In this video, we will understand how to interface liquid crystal display to the 8051 microcontroller. We will also understand how to program 8051 microcontroller to display a message over the LCD display. Here, this is how an LCD looks like. Okay. Here, I have used 5x7 2 line and 16 character LCD display. 5x7 is the matrix. There are 5 dots and 7 rows of 5 dots. Over this, the character gets displayed. Okay. Here, using this 5x7 matrix, I can display a number, I can display an alphabet, I can even display special characters. Okay, this is the advantage of LCD display over the 7 segment display, where in 7 segment display I can display only numbers. Okay, 2 line, as you can see, there are 2 lines over which I can display, and it is a 16 character of each. Each line I can display 16 characters, so total I can display 32 characters using this LCD. And it is an IC. This LCD is an IC. It is a 14-pin IC. You can see here there are 8 data lines, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. It is a 14-pin IC which gets interfaced to the 8051 microcontroller. I will be using 2 ports of 8051 microcontroller to interface the LCD. The entire port 0 I will be using to interface the LCD, and 2 pins of port 3. 2 pins of port 3 I will be using other than port 0 to interface the LCD. Here port 3.3 is connected to register select, port 3.2 is connected to the enable pin of the LCD. Okay. So coming here, whatever the information which the 8051 microcontroller wants to send, it will be sending through port 0. So the information is sent through port 0. This information is of two types. It might be a command or it might be a data. Here data is ASCII value. This is nothing but hex. All these, either it might be a command or it might be a data, it is a hexadecimal value. It is an 8-bit hexadecimal value. As port 0 is 8-bit, so it is an 8-bit hexadecimal value. The information coming from 8051 microcontroller, it may be a command or it may be a data. This differentiation has to be told by the microcontroller whether it is sending a command or whether it is sending a data. Okay, this differentiation is told by port pin 3.3 through register select. If the register select is 0, then it is command. If the register select pin is 1, it is data. Here, what is this command and what is this data is? Command is an information sent by the 8051 microcontroller to the LCD to obey. And the information sent by the 8051 microcontroller, if it is a data, then the data information has to be displayed. So command is to obey and data is to display. This is the difference between the two types of the information. Okay. And this differentiation has to be told by the 8051 microcontroller, and it will tell through port 3.3, which is connected to register select. Okay, if the register select pin is 0, then the information sent by the 8051 microcontroller to the LCD is command. If the register select pin is 1, then it is data. Okay, every time the information sent, a high to low transition has to be made to the enable pin. A high to low transition has to be made to the enable pin such that the information get latched. The information can be a data or command. So every time an information is sent by the 8051 microcontroller, a high to low transition has to be made through port 3.2 to the enable pin of the LCD. Okay, then the information gets latched, and if at all it is command, it will be obeyed, or else if at all it is data, it will be displayed. Then the next pin is read write pin, read write bar pin of the LCD. Here we are only writing the data to the LCD, that's why I have grounded it as it is read write bar. So we are only writing here onto the LCD, that's why this particular pin is grounded. Okay, then coming to these three pins, it is VCC. As you know that VCC, it gets connected to the 5 volt, and VSS is the ground which we will connect, and in between there is a pot. VEE is the pin which is connected to a potentiometer. As we vary the potentiometer, so we can vary the brightness of the display. So we can control the brightness of the display through this VEE pin. Okay, next we will understand what are these commands. Okay, data, we know that whatever we want to display, that becomes a data. But what are these commands are? Here you can see that there is a list of commands. There is a list of commands given by the manufacturer of the LCD. These are provided in the data sheet of the LCD. So who designs these LCD? Okay, as you can see, there are numerous number of commands. If the command is 01, it means that clear display screen. If it is 02, it is return home. If at all it is 04H, then it is decrement cursor. 06H, increment cursor. Okay, decrement means move the cursor to the left. Increment means move the cursor to the right. 05H, shift display right. 7, shift display left. 8, display off, cursor off. 0AH, display off, cursor on. C, display on, cursor off. E, display on, cursor blinking. 10, shift cursor position to left. 14, shift cursor position to right. 18, shift the entire display to the left. 1CH, shift the entire display to the right. 80, force cursor to the beginning of the first line. You understand here? 80 means force cursor to the beginning of the first line. It means that this is the address of the 80H is the address of the first line, first character. Then this becomes 81. Then this becomes 82. These are the address of the each of these display units. Then so on, it becomes up to 16 characters. So it will be 8F. We started with 0, then we will end with F. So 16 characters in the first line. Whereas the address of the second line, as you can see here, C0 means force the cursor to the beginning of the second line. So this is the beginning of the second line. This is the address of the second line, C0. Then it will become C1 is the address of the second character in the second line. C2 is the third position in the second line, and so on. Then this will become CF. This will become CE. This is AD. So these are the addresses. It means that it provides the programmer to display either to the left or to the extreme right or in between. Wherever he wishes to display, he can display. So the programmer has the liberty to use the LCD screen to display wherever he wants. So through these addresses. Okay. And coming to here, the last command, 38. It means that to select 2 line and 5 cross 7 matrix. 2 lines of display and 5 cross 7 matrix is the display format. Okay. Out of these commands, few of the commands I will be using in my program. Which are those commands? I will be using 38. First command I will be using 38 to select 2 line and 5 cross 7 matrix. And I will be using E0EH, display on, cursor blinking. Third command I will be using 01. It means that clear display screen. If at all previously there are any display happening, it will clear the screen. Next, one more I will be using, that is 80H, to select where I want to display. I will be displaying from the extreme left in the first line. So it means that 80H means first line and the extreme left block. Okay. So this is about the LCD IC and their commands. Okay, now we will understand how to program the 8051 microcontroller to display a message. Okay, So this program consists of three parts. Actually, one is command subprogram. Okay. Next, one more is data subprogram, and the other one is delay program. Okay, like this we are writing the program. Okay, command means when the information sent by the 8051 microcontroller is a command, then I'll execute command program. So you can see here, this is my command program. Okay, next, if the information sent by the 8051 microcontroller is a data, then I'll execute data program. Okay, then coming to delay program, every time I send an information, the information can be a command or a data, I will call this delay program. Means microcontroller, after sending the information, okay, it will wait for certain amount of time so that LCD gets enough time to display the data or to obey the command. That's why this delay is of few milliseconds. So that is the duration given by the microcontroller to the LCD display to display the data or to obey the command before it sends the next command or next data. Okay, coming to the program, we will understand the program. See, these are my commands. As I told, 38 0E 01 ATH, these are the four commands which I'll be sending. Okay, so what I am doing here, whatever the command I have to send, I will take it in accumulator. Okay, then call a subroutine program as command. Okay, what happens in the command? Let's see here. In the command subprogram, I will clear P3.3. It means that register select pin is 0. It means what? It is command. The information sent by the microcontroller to the LCD is a command. Okay, the information is a command. Then whatever was there in the accumulator will be transferred to port 0. Port 0 is what is connected to the LCD for data, for the information has to be sent. Okay, that information is sent to the port 0. A port from the accumulator, it is sent to the port 0, which in turn is connected to LCD. Okay, then after sending the information, what I'll do is I'll set 3.3, that is here enable pin I am making high. Enable set means set bit, means I am making the enable pin high. After certain delay, I will clear that pin. I will clear that pin, making a high to low transition. Means I latched the information which is there onto the port 0. As it is a command, this command will be obeyed. Okay, what is the first command I sent? 38. It means that select 2 line 5 cross 7 matrix. Okay, next I'll call a delay. After sending the first command, before I send the next command, I'll call a delay. It means that I'm giving enough time for the LCD display to obey that command. Okay, next, 0 is the next command, and I call a command subroutine. Same program is executed. Okay, what is happening here? Register select, I am making it as 0, telling the LCD display that the information sent is a command, and I am pulling a high to low transition onto the enable pin, making the information to latch and making the LCD to obey the command. So 0E means cursor display on, cursor blinking. 01 means clear display screen. ATH means select the first line and extreme left position of the LCD display. Okay, next, this is the command program, or this is the first part of the program is all about commands, sending the commands. Now I'll send the information. So when I write, I'm trying to display KSIT over the LCD. So ASCII value of K is obtained by putting the K in the single inverted quote, and when I write like this, it will obtain the ASCII value of K onto the accumulator. Okay, here also ASCII value of S to A, ASCII value of I to the A, ASCII value of T to the A, and every time the accumulator is loaded with the ASCII value of the character which I want to display,
I'll call a call data. So let's see what is happening in the call data subprogram. Here data, I will set bit port 3.3. It means that I'm making register select to 1. It means that the information sent by the microcontroller is data. It is not command, it is data. Now I supplied the port A to the accumulator contents to the port 0. Next, a high to low transition, set bit and then delay, set bit, delay and then clear port 3.2. So high to low transition, it means that latch this data onto the LCD which will be taken and it will be displayed. As it is a data, it gets displayed. Okay, next, coming back, I'll do the same for yes, I'll do the same for I, I'll do the same for T. Before sending the yes, after sending the K, before sending the yes, there is a delay program. This delay program ensures that between two information sent by the microcontroller, the LCD gets enough time to obey the command or to display the data. Awesome. Okay, we'll see the execution of the LCD program now. LCD.asm is my program. I have added to the target file and Nitish is my project name. LCD.asm is my program file. This is the same program which I have explained, written on the board and explained to you. Okay, here small change I have to make. I'll save the program, I'll build it, and as you can see there are zero errors, zero warnings. Now I'll debug. Okay, then a target file will be created, a hex file will be created, and COM port is 24, it's already selected. Now I'll select the project file as nitish.hex, which I have to transfer it to the kit. So when I transfer it to the kit, okay, here it's showing chip verification successful. Okay, it means that program is successfully dumped onto the kit. And you can see here on the screen, you can see here on the LCD screen, in the first line KSIT it is written. As the address I have selected as 80H, then it is the first block in the first line. Hence K is displayed at that position and then followed by SIT. Okay. Next, I'll show you how to display the same message in the second line. Okay. Color change I'll make. Instead of 80, what I'll do is I'll add C0. C0 is the address of the second line and first block. Second line and first block. I'll come out of the debug. I've made the corrections. I change the address of the display from 80 to C0. I will save the program, build it. There are zero errors, debug. Now I'll load the program once again. Now program it. Chip verification successful, and you can see that the display is displayed in the second line. So it was earlier in the first line, now it has displayed in the second line. Okay. Before all, I want to display different characters, then I'll change the program and I'll show you how to display the different characters. So instead of K, I'll display it as ECE. ECE department. So for department I'll write D. Okay, ECED. This is the information which has to be displayed. This has to be replaced by KSIT. Now let's see whether it will work or not. I have built it. Zero errors, debug. COM port is 24. File loadx. Nitish is my project name. Nitish.hex is the hex file. Program it, showing that chip verification successful, and you can see that ECED is displayed. It means that ECE department. Now KSIT has been replaced by ECE